But what we're going to do, this is a fantasy on one note, and it involves, if you're up for it, some audience participation. Yeah, excellent. I like that. That's correct. This is simply, it's a fantasy on one note. So it's a four-part fantasy, and Paul Wiancko is going to play one note, a drone middle C, the entire time, and he's going to show it to you now. He has been practicing backstage. Now, here's the hard part. You're gonna hum that note along with him. So just give it a sense to get in your system here. That note, right? Okay, great. So the whole point, there is a point, apart from just humming. The cool thing about this piece is that note changes how it feels based on the music around it. So you're going to be part of this quintet on stage, you know, as an example. So let's get our note going here. Okay, well, here's the opening. Just see how it makes you feel. So this is, the cool thing about music is you don't have to know anything to get it, to be affected by it. Does that make sense? So the same note, if we play in minor, will make you feel totally different. So here's our C again. Feel this now. Isn't that great? So the same pitch goes from being in the opening, ha, to yeah. So that's major minor. And you don't even have to know what it means, but you can feel it. Yeah? Okay, slow fast, same sort of vibe. Here's a slow version of this music. Yeah. Keep going. Good. Isn't that great? So it's, again, the same pitch, now you're quivering with excitement. So don't be shy, hum along, just sort of feel these transformations during, it's shorter than the introduction, this piece. But meaningfully different based on the music around you when you're singing with Paul. So here's Purcell's fantasy on one note.
Now we have some Henry Purcell. This is a sonata in three parts. You might be wondering what sonata is. Sonata in this time period just simply means sounded thing played by instruments, as opposed to the toccata, toccare, to touch, that's the keyboard, or a cantata, which is something that's sung. You have a sonata. This has five parts, a kind of fugue-like theme with some variations. You'll hear us passing back and forth. A quick vivace, an adagio, a presto, and finally a largo. And if you know Henry Purcell's Dido and Aeneas, it reminds me very much of Dido's lament and is one of the most beautiful instrumental things I think he ever wrote.
Thank you.
Paul, what are we going to hear here? What do we got?
Well, first of all, Geoff and St. Lawrence, I have to thank you so much for bringing this piece into existence with me and making these dreams come true for me. Wow. Thank you so much.
Honor.
This piece, it's called Tiny Doors to Big Worlds. It's a piece that I've wanted to exist my whole life, even before I was a composer. I love the Schubert Quintet, and I just always wish there was something else to play alongside it. I've never been great at writing music about a particular thing. If someone said, you know, write a piece about clouds in wintertime, I don't know if I'd be able to do it. It's better to let the subject matter reveal itself through the compositional process, because music can convey so many things that words can't. So that concept itself was the basis of this piece, thinking about what was happening in the world and what continues to happen in the world every day, and letting fragments of reality seep into the music and kind of take me in unexpected directions. So that spirit of deviance and discovery is the spirit in which this piece exists.
Oh yeah, we'll do that. So just for your housekeeping, there are three movements. First movement, a beautiful slow movement, really exquisite. And there's so many incredible love duets for the two cellos in this piece. It's really remarkable. It's sort of funny because Ayane and Paul have a duo, and it's got a great name. It's called Ayane and Paul. But we've actually superseded that with Chris and Paul as the new duo. So there are three movements, and this is where we need your help. We love to feel, and actually you guys are better than any audience on the planet, right? I mean, feeling that you're with us. The third movement begins with a quote from the aforementioned Schubert double cello quintet, which I know you hardcore fans all know. Here's the scherzo from the Schubert. So there'll be an incredibly cool moment right at the beginning of the third movement where there's a Wiancko version of that. And what we need you to do is go, oh, I get that, yeah. Okay? Just so we know you're with us.
That's Schubert.
Wow. He got a new cell phone, and he's just like...
He doesn't know how to turn it off yet.
No, he's calling.
Oh. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.